So, finally, we are doing this. This is going to be the most heart-to-heart conversation I've ever had in a video. The most honest video and probably the most strongest video that I've ever done. I've been thinking a lot if I should do this or not. But then I thought, you know, that authenticity is probably more important than, you know, perfection. And that being real is more important than being right all the time. And this has been, you know, weighing heavy on my heart since very long. So I thought, you know, let's just do it, you know. So I want to be very honest to you in this video. I mean, a lot of you know me for the little works that I'm doing. But I'm 19 and I don't have any close friends at all. Yeah, that's true. I do have mentors I can call 11 p.m. at night. I do have students, or rather call them brothers and sisters, who do anything if I ask for help. But I don't have any close friends at all. And it's not that, you know, I'm sad about it necessarily. You know, I am really happy with my life and what I get to do. I cry a few times a week, you know, out of happiness. But this is a hole that I have. This is a vacancy, I mean, emptiness, you know, one part of it. Because sometimes you just want to talk to people, you know, and there's nobody, you know, you could have a conversation about, hey, this is what happened that was bad and this is what I feel, or hey, this is, you know, maybe just heart-to-heart conversations. I do have like mentors and elder people, but nothing like friends and stuff. If you are into the same phase, maybe this video is for you. If you have been through that phase, this video is for you. If you are not into that phase, this video is for you, because you never know where future is going to bring you. So here's how it happened for me. When I was in school, I'm sharing this for the first time openly. I was into an addiction. Maybe I'll make a video about it later. And I was super bullied, like by my seniors, by juniors, by classmates. I used to be hit physically, maybe sometimes, and I was verbally abused or made fun of like every day. My teachers used to do that, but you know, because of all of those experiences that I had, I had never made close friends. I had one to two people that seemed to be close friends, but you know, they would just rush some, you know, just leave me alone sometimes and do this stuff, and I'd feel all alone, you know. And maybe that's where it came from, I don't know. But when I went into plus two, I was determined that I want to make friends. And this Vaibhav is like, you don't know this guy, you know, I'm completely different since then. In 2017, when I went to college, in my plus twos, I decided that, you know, I want to be more open towards friends, or maybe I should open up in life and I don't want to get bullied anymore and stuff. And, you know, that's when I started to try to fit in. I would do things that I probably would not love to sometimes, and I had a few friends at that point of time, and they were like good friends, used to hang out and stuff like that. But I went to Calcutta and I had this experience called Rashtriya Sanskar Nirman Shivir. I mean, that was super powerful for me. And once I was back, you know, I started dreaming. I had a vision for my life. I want to do something. I did not know what that was, but that was, I think, a breakthrough into my life. And once I was back, I was determined to do something. So, you know, I tried to communicate this to my those friend group that I had, but nobody would resonate with that vision again. So I said, let them go once again. I'll be all alone once again, because I want to choose that, you know, dream. And I did not feel like I'll be lonely and stuff at that point of time. And I started chasing, I started doing stuff here and there. I did few things that everyone thought was impossible. We did the largest principal summit in the whole province and state. We called in international trainers from UK, Dubai, did events with my company, SSI and stuff. And you know, after I had my plus twos done, and my college was supportive with that for sure. Even my school was supportive with what I was doing. But you know, that's a different story altogether. But when I went to college, I again had the same vision. I want to chase my goals. I want to chase my dreams. And I was so close towards having close friends that in general, I would talk to people. I'm really good at communicating. I would talk well to people. I go to conference. I'll make everybody friends. Even now when I go to college, like I have all these friends, I talk to everybody, I have good relations with everybody, but I have nobody I can really talk to, my heart to, you know, that's how it was, it is right now. Anyways, when I came to college, I was like, yo, I want to change this, and I've been doing since then, ever since, you know, I've been doing things. But now I have realized something in the last 6 months, 1 year, that there's one thing I'm really bad at, and that is having close friends. Like, I have literally nobody, and that sometimes make you feel the other way around, you know. I feel a little bit otherwise I'm making this video, because I'm just going too vulnerable. I've never been this vulnerable in videos. But here's the thing, you know, it's not that I did not try. Initially I was very close. I would see that some girl is proposing me, or, you know, showing some signs that they're interested and stuff, and I'd be like, hey sister, I would just put sister into the chat, you know, and they'd be like, are you kidding me? And I would just end it over there sometimes, even if I wanted to or did not want to and stuff like that. But in the last 6 months to 1 year, you know, because, you know, with all of the things happening, now I have a different perspective altogether. And it's not that after some time, you know, when I started feeling I need to have somebody I can talk to at the end of the day, you know. As you grow older, I'm 19 now, you need to have people that you can discuss your, if nothing else, dreams with. You can just have fun and hang out with, you know. But I find it so hard to relate to people in general. I'm just super duper weird or something, I don't know. And I'm okay with that. But, you know, I tried making friends with people, like close friendships with people. I'm good with everybody, but close friendships. And it simply doesn't work out for me, you know, because I try to have a conversation with people, and what I'm talking about makes people bored sometimes. And, like, most important of all, what like in general I hear about, I get super bored, and I just, you know, sometimes I let go of people, sometimes people let go of me, whatever it is, you know. But what I've realized through this journey, and if there's one point I'm trying to make through this video, this is this that I'm seeing now. That, you know, all of us were so awesome as we were kids. If you remember, you used to do something really well. You were really enjoying in life, you know. You had a vibe of your own. You passed the vibe check in your own way. But what happened over time is you wanted to be a part of that certain group, or, you know, you wanted to be friends with these people, or you want to be part of that cool gang, and then you just left off who you were, you know. We compromise ourselves in that process, and ever since you have been that person who are a part of a, you know, a group, you're doing things to try to fit in. That's never been you, and that's why we, you know, we miss out on so much of joy in life. I am able to experience so much of joy. I mean, I cry out of happiness sometimes. I open up. Sometimes I feel really vacant. I have no friends. And I'm opening up towards it because I want to have people I can talk to. But also, no matter what, don't you dare fit in, you know, just so that you can look cool or good, feel good about yourself. I know you'll feel lonely sometimes. Maybe you're not supposed to, I don't know. But it is worth it that you don't sacrifice being yourself. And being yourself does not mean you're serious about goals, career. I don't mean nothing of that, you know. I just mean that you need to have fun being yourself. Okay to have fun with friends. Okay to have girlfriends, maybe if you have certain age of majority. Okay to have boyfriends. Okay to do anything you want, you know. But make sure in the process of that, at least these people that you sit around with have a dream, if nothing else. I want to do something with life. And when you share your dreams with them, they're going to be like, okay, wow, that's awesome. They are curious about your dreams, and you are curious about the other people as well, you know. So that's what I wanted to make a point, you know. I just felt like, you know, you feel like you don't have anybody to talk to sometimes. You're all lonely, you know. But you're happy at the same time, but then you feel at the same time that there's this vacant part of it. I don't know what the point of this video. I just felt like I should speak my heart out, because this was holding on to me since such a long time, and I wanted to have these honest conversations. So if there's any one point of this video, and again, I'm still learning and exploring how this works, because I don't have any close friends yet, and I do feel bad about it sometimes. But make sure you don't compromise yourself to be somebody else or to be a part of certain group, because when you start doing that, you lose yourself. And when you are yourself, find somebody who can accept you as you are, you know. And when you are able to be yourself, the joy in life is so much freaking more, you know. I think that's enough for this video. I don't know. I mean, I've never made a video like this, so I don't know how this works out with you guys. If you resonate even 1 inch, or if you have watched through, I guess it's 10 minutes or something, please do comment below whatever you think, whatever you feel like. And yeah, I mean, if you would want more honest conversations like this, I'd love to. And thank you so much for watching this so far. I'll see you in the next video. Maybe I can learn more about having close friends with them, or maybe I have close friends then I don't know. Okay, thank you so much. Bye bye.